Welcome back to the channel. I had a commenter ask about film scratches, so I figured we'd take a look on how to fix some of those. First example we have here is from The Good, the Bad, and the Ugly. Here's our before, here's our after. We've got this issue in the upper left here. And our second example here is from Quentin Tarantino's Death Proof. And here's our before and after. This one could be cleaned up a little bit more over here on the left, but I'll show you what we can do to fix that as we get to that shot. So the first one here, I ended up using the automatic dirt removal. So let's reset this node and I'll show you how to set the parameters on that. This one's found under the Resolve Effects Revival. It's the first option called Automatic Dirt Removal. I'll drop that on. You can also search for your plugins now in Resolve 20.1. If you hit Shift Space and start typing the name of the plugin, you can actually grab it from the list and it will apply it to the node you're on. All right, so let's take a look at the tools here. First, we have Motion Estimate Type. I'm going to move that to Better. Better uses more processing power, but it does seem to work quite a bit better. And as you can see, even just dropping that on, there's a pretty good reduction in the film stains here and the scratch or scrape in the upper left. Next parameter is called neighbor frames. Now, because this scratch is a couple frames long, it needs to look further than just one or two frames ahead. So I'm going to move that to 4 because we have a long enough shot to do that. And now if we look, we're getting a little bit more reduction. Now we have repair strength and dirt size threshold. So repair strength is just how aggressive the plugin will be. And the threshold is you dialing it in on what you're saying is the problem you're looking for or stains. And this is able to be seen with the show repair mask. So if we highlight this, anything that's white will be dubbed something to fix. And anything that's grayed out will be left alone. So if we go way down on our threshold, you can actually see right here, we're getting the outline of where the mountain meets the sky. So we don't want that to be altered or anything like that. This also brings nearly the silhouette of both horses in. We don't want to have any of those getting included in the fix. So we can slide our threshold up a little and you can see it starts to soften. And then we have fine controls. There's a motion threshold. This would be if you have scattered dirt or something moving really quickly, it takes that into effect. I'm going to leave that at 100. And then we have edge ignore, and this will work for our high contrast points. So something like right here where our original fix was a dark spot over the lighter cloud or sky, it will take that into consideration. As you can see, if we start out at 0 and move our way up, it almost brings the stain back, but that'll help you blend in depending on your situation. And then with the threshold, we can lower that down and we'll pretty much get rid of the stain almost in its entirety. So that's our first shot. Second shot, I tried something similar. So what I'm gonna do is reset all these nodes. I'll add one in. And if we try the automatic dirt removal, I'm going to throw that on and you can see we're just getting these weird artifacts here. It's on better in 4 again, whatever our last settings were. We could dial our strength back, but it just really doesn't address the scratch very well. Next up, I gave the dust buster a try, and this one you actually have to draw over the problem area. And you could use a rectangle or an ellipse or a small patch. So I'll go with ellipse. And we'll draw it from outside the frame and sort of cover the problem area here. As you can see, it starts to blur it. And if we let go and zoom in, I'll shut the UI off. You can see it does get rid of the scratch, but we've got some disjointment and skewing on the image here. Now, if we turn this back on and grab it, we can adjust a little bit of soft edge here. We can move the size around a bit. We're still getting some doubling of the image. Now we can go plus and minus one frame, but if we do that, it's looking ahead to the next cut. So that's not going to work for us. There is one called spatial that adds kind of a vertical blur to it called variability. That one I don't really like the results on either. So I wasn't real happy with the results I was getting with any of these. So I'll show you what I ended up doing. I actually went back to our edit page and I copied our clip. So let me reset everything here. So here's our clip as it is with no color correction or anything on it. I just grab it and option copy it right above. I'm gonna take the top clip and reduce the opacity here to around 50. Doesn't have to be perfect. And we're gonna take this bottom clip and shift it up to just make a donor spot basically of where this line is. So if we zoom in and I'll just raise this clip with the Y parameter. Now you can see as we lift it up, we've got some image below that doesn't have the scratch. And maybe something like that. I'll try to go pretty minimal. And now we take our top clip and we set our opacity back to 100%. I'm just going to double click that. And what we're going to do is cut a hole in this top clip to reveal the bottom clip with the shifted image underneath. So I'm going to choose the top clip again and go back to the color page. And I'm going to use a curve to poke a hole in this top clip here, or cut a hole. So let's go ahead and grab the curve tool. I'm going to go just above our scratch, just below it. I'm going to go off screen to give us a little bit of room, and then we'll close the window. And now if we highlight it, we've essentially saved everything inside the window. So we need to invert that. I'm going to hit this little button right down here on the right, and that'll invert our selection. So now the exposed part is the original image, and we've cut a hole in this part of the image inside the box. Now, to get the bottom image to show through, we need to hook up our alpha output. That's this little blue dot. If we right click and you don't see that blue dot, just choose add alpha output, and then grab the blue square from your node and connect that over to the blue circle, and that will connect the alpha output back to your timeline. Now, if we shut off this overlay here, we have the hole, our donor hole, but we need to move it around to blur this line. So I need to adjust this softness parameters here in our power window. If I increase soft, you can see it starts to blur it a little. It looks like I need to come up a hair. So I'm going to pan it, or tilt it rather, and just get it right on the line. I don't know if you could see that or not. I'm just getting it to hover right above the scratch right here. So here we're off the scratch. I'm going to move our way to the scratch just to get it right about there. And then we can mess with the inside and outside softness to get it to blend a little bit better. Looks like we got to come up just a hair because we got a little bit of the line exposed on the left side of the screen. Let me turn this back on. We could actually grab it here and just sort of line it up as we see it. I'm going to use my external monitor and just sort of look where it's landing. So without the overlay, this is pretty much what I'm looking at. And I'm just getting this top line on the left side here to just block out that scratch. And same thing with the middle. We could always add another tangent here if we needed to arc it a bit. So I'm just getting it right over the line. So now we're looking like this, something like that. So here's before and after. So now we need to soften this up a little bit just so it's not such a harsh line. So I'll do that maybe with the outside soft and just keep an eye on the image and see when we're revealing that line again. And then try the inside of here. So you just got to play with a combo of all those. So this is our before after. We still got a little bit of harshness. We could add another window over the top and kind of blur it a little bit. And then there is a little bit of skewing on the lip here where our window is. What we can do there is grab the bottom image from the edit page and shift it over a little bit. So we could either go back to the edit page here and select that clip and start moving it here, or we can grab that clip right here, go over here to our sizing, and this gives us some options to move the image around. Now, because it's one big long strip here, it's going to start skewing on the ear and the hair, but we're mainly concerned right here on the lip portion. So I'm just going to pan this over just a little bit So we got to split the difference. And we're also revealing the edge right here. So maybe we could zoom it just a little bit. Something like that. And we're keeping an eye on these vertical lines of whatever's in the background here. So we still have a little bit of a harsh edge on this window. If we want to go back to our window controls on the top clip here, we can mess around with the softness a bit more. So I'll shut the overlay off and just dial around the softness until it starts to smooth out a little bit more. So this one's a pretty hard scratch to fix. I would probably think a real post house would have a DRS company do it, where you basically paint it, but you could do infusion. But this is one option here with using your power windows. And we saw the revival tools just weren't getting the job done. So there's our before and after. All right, so there's a few different options using automatic dirt removal, dust buster, and the kind of clone option where you cut a hole in the image. All right, thanks for watching. As always, leave a comment down below if you guys got some kind of video topic you want me to make a video on, and I'll talk to you guys on the next one.